Hello. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the types of metamorphism. In the earlier lecture, I have said that there are different types of metamorphism depending on the temperature and pressure regime, which affect the changes or which causes the core rock to recrystallize. So there are different types of metamorphism. If the temperature is the dominant factor, then it can be a contact metamorphism. If the pressure is the dominant factor, it can be some other type of metamorphism. And if it occur over a large area, it is known as a regional metamorphism. There is no clear-cut classification for a metamorphism, but here we will be trying to discuss the types of metamorphism depending on the agents which is causing the metamorphism. The first type of metamorphism is a contact metamorphism. This is a type of metamorphism which occurs in a country rock where an igneous intrusion has been occurred. The term country rock refers to the rock which has been intruded or the rock which is surrounding the igneous intrusion. As you can see, a small area surrounding the rock has been subjected to the heating, so that the metamorphism will be limited to a smaller area where the heat can reach. Only a small area will be subjected to heating due to the intrusion. So the metamorphism is only limited to that particular area. And the area or the zone where the contact metamorphism has taken place is known as a contact orion or a metamorphic orion. And as you can see, the metamorphic grade will increases from all direction towards the igneous intrusions. Outside the contact aureole, the country rock will be remain unchanged. The contact metamorphism is dependent on the temperature contrast between the surrounding rocks and the intruding magma. Since the temperature contrast is high in deeper rocks where pressure is low, the contact metamorphism is also known as a high temperature, low pressure metamorphism. And the rocks which are formed in this contact metamorphism are fine-grained and non-foliated, and they are known as hornfels. Close to the igneous intrusion, it is known as a metasomatic aureole or a hydrothermal aureole, where the hot fluids will have a greater chance for changing into another rock. And further away from the intrusion, the heat will be the primary cause. And the zone of contact aureole is entirely dependent on the size of the intrusion as well as the nature of fluid present in the intrusion. If fluid is absent, the contact aureole will be very small. The assemblage of new minerals that is formed as a result of contact metamorphism is entirely dependent on the nature of the parent rock. Take the case of a complex assemblage of sandstone and shale. In such a case, anhydrous minerals such as garnet and pyroxene occur near to the intrusive. Then in the middle range, there occur the hydrous minerals such as amphibole and epidote. And on the lower intensity, minerals will be like chlorite and serpentine will be formed at the farther end from the contact aureole. And when the intrusion occurs into, or the intrusion peers into a carbonate rock, such as a limestone or a dolostone, then the carbonate react with the silica from the intrusion to form a skarn deposit. And there occur many lime-bearing silicate deposit will be formed in such a scenario. The next type of metamorphism is a cataclastic metamorphism. It is also known as a dynamic metamorphism. It is a metamorphism which is formed as a result of a faulting or a thrusting. Faulting is nothing but the relative movement of two rock bodies slide past each other. And due to this sliding, the rock which has been between these two rock bodies will get pulverized, sheared, and will be formed, and they form a new rock due to the high shear strength. The dominant factor in this cataclastic type of metamorphism is the pressure, and which is the pressure, the nature of pressure here is a directed one. There is a small temperature also in this type of metamorphism. This temperature may be formed as a result of the friction heat produced due to the faulting or thrusting. And the shearing or the faulting can be a short leave that is spanning over some years, or it may be a long leave that is spanning over a millions of years. The dynamic metamorphism involves high shear stress, high pressure, high strain, high fluid partial pressure, and it also includes variable temperature. In many instances, water also plays a very fundamental role. The crushed rocks in faults are known as fault brushes, which consist of angular fragments of chondral rock in a matrix of crushed or powdered or pulverized rock, which is cemented by quartz or calcite. Fluid moves very easily along the fault zone and between the grain boundaries and through cracks and fissures. These fluids are able to transport a large amount of silica, carbonates and all other minerals in way of solution. Pseudotachylite is a fault zone rock which is black and glassy. It occurs as narrow dikes and veins, and it is formed due to the frictional melting of the chondral rock. And the type of rock are the millonites, which are partially recrystallized rock with pronounced foliation that are produced by the intense shearing due to a large scale movement along a fault or a thrust. The different types of rock formed by the dynamic metamorphism vary with the depth from the surface. As we go deep into their surface, the temperature and pressure goes increasing. So the rocks which are formed by the cataclysmic or dynamic metamorphism in such a situation will be different from the one which is formed in the surface of the earth.